interpretations, a gender divide. An executive shared the difficulty she had getting agreement from the male leaders in her organization. As part of the coaching, I suggested that a check-in with a male mentor was in order. She hesitated. It turns out she'd already asked her boss to suggest a better approach to achieving yeses, and his response was uninformative, not to mention downright disappointing. What was his advice? He told me to be prepared. That was it. Then she asserted in frustration, "Of course I prepare." I asked, "What did the recommendation mean to you?" She translated prepared as properly researched, contains solid ideas, no spelling errors, everything footnoted, well written, looked good, primed to discuss controversial points. She nailed being prepared based on her definition. Unhappily, her actions didn't exhibit what her male boss intended when he offered his pithy guidance. What he meant was all the items on her list, as well as integrating a much broader array of activities, such as Scout the Territory, which focuses on the political alignments indispensable to your success. Do you have any enemies, opposition to the proposal? If so, what do they have against the recommendation? How powerful is the vote against your proposal? How will you counteract their resistance? Do you have allies? If yes, why are they supporting the proposal? Is there anything they can do to turn the tide in your favor? How many resources are your opposition or allies willing to dedicate toward the final acceptance or rejection of the proposition? Take the high ground before going into battle tackles the strategic battle planning that has you winning the war. How entrenched is the resistance? What would it take to move them from their position? Is the outcome worth your effort? Do you have enough support to get the proposal approved? If not, is a tactical retreat to win the battle another day a better option? It's rarely what you do in the meeting that achieves the victory. Rather, it is the behind-the-scenes powwows which garner the win. If you don't secure the first scrimmage, what's your backup strategy to win the war? Symptoms of this gender-specific communication divide often emerge. Men and women are using identical words. However, the messages given or received are at odds. It would be humorous if it weren't so deadly serious. It is up to each to assume responsibility for their part of the equation and the solution. So if you're a guy and think you're doing a stellar mentor job of women in your organization, perhaps you're not as good as you presume. Have you confirmed, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that the women you are communicating with are receiving the career guidance you intend? If they don't, it's up to you to make sure they do, or you're wasting your time. More importantly, you're harming your relationships when women misconstrue your message. If you're a gal and believe the male mentors in your life aren't doing such a great job, ask more questions. Get inside their head. You need to make sure you're taking in the gems of wisdom as intended, not simply brushing them aside because you don't appreciate the nuances. If you ask and then appear not to follow through, you're dooming yourself. Better communication doesn't mean either the man or the woman must tie themselves into knots. It entails putting a bit more effort into recognizing, respecting, and honoring the difference. Often, at the root of ineffective office exchanges is gender intelligence. If this got your female executive growth juices flowing, you'll want to check out thrivewithnancy.com for many more resources.